But please recall that the Credit Star Union of Universities, ASU, went on strike on 1st of July 2013 on the grievances of non-implementation of the federal government ASU agreement signed in 2009. In reaction, the federal government initiated a series of meetings between her team, led by the Secretary of the Government of the Federation, including the Honorable Ministers of Education, the Honorable Finance, the Honorable Minister of Finance and Coordinating Minister of the Economy, the Minister of Labor and Productivity, and all top government officials with the executive of ASU. It should be noted that a joint Senate and House Committees on Education also intervened without success. A committee was also inaugurated for the implementation of the needs assessment report. As a further demonstration of government's commitment to resolve the crisis, His Excellency Architect Namale Sambo, GCON, Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, on behalf of government, led the team comprising the Honorable Minister of State of Education, the Executive Secretary, NUC, the Permanent Secretary, and as Committee of Vice Chancellors, and invited ASU to a meeting where the two contentious issues of earned allowance, academic allowances, and funding for the modernization of universities were discussed and resolutions reached. There was still no positive response from ASU. Consequently, on 4th of November 2013, in a 13-hour meeting, His Excellency, Mr. President, Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, GCFR, met with ASU executive, the labor union leaders for the Nigerian Labor Congress, and the Trade Union Congress, where all the issues were resolved and firm commitments made to address the lingering crime issues. It is noteworthy that Mr. President's gesture was more than sufficient to guarantee the commitment of government to address all issues as resolved at the meeting with Mr. President. At the end of the meeting with Mr. President, the ASU executive promised to meet with ISNEC to present the resolutions reached and report back by Friday, November 8, 2013. It is unfortunate that while traveling to attend the next meeting in Kano, we lost a key member and former president of the union, Professor Festus Siyaye. Government sympathizes with the families of late Siyaye and ASU. It is amazing, however, that 3 weeks after the meeting with Mr. President, ASU responded by giving new conditions for suspending the farm board strike. Government has reviewed the entire situation and has come to the conclusion that the continuation of the strike action is an attempt by ASU to sabotage all efforts to address the issues. As a responsible government, we cannot allow the continuous closure of our public universities for this length of time that the fact was, and this poses danger to the education system, the future of our youth, and national development. Consequently, the federal government has directed as follows. 1. All vice chancellors of federal universities that are currently on strike should immediately reopen for academic and allied activities as directed by their pro-chancellors. 2. Vice chancellors should ensure that staff who resume for work are provided with enabling environment for academic and allied activities. 3. Any academic staff who fails to resume on or before the 4th of December 2013 automatically ceases to be a staff of the institution. And 4. Vice chancellors are also directed to advertise vacancies internal and external in their institutions. The National Universities Commission is hereby directed to monitor the compliance of these directives by the various institutions. The federal government has met all its commitments and obligations to respect to the federal government ASU 2009 agreement. We appeal to all stakeholders to appreciate the position of government which is in the best interest.